We left the last video discussing the northern and southernmost points that the sun ever reaches. So in this point here, that would be the northernmost point that the sun ever reaches on the earth. And down here, that would be the southernmost point. In other words, the sun never moves further north than this point, and never moves further south than that point. And of course, the equator sits in between. And so it turns out that because of those reasons there, this northern southernmost points, turns out there's another line, another couple lines you can draw on the earth. One would be right here, and one would be right here. And so it turns out that all told, there's actually three of these lines on the earth, the equator and two others. I'll go ahead and draw the lower one right here on this figure and the upper one right here on this figure. There's actually three lines on the earth like that, indicating sort of the midpoint, the northernmost point, and the southernmost point. Let's just go down here and collect all these thoughts together here like this. So here would be the earth like this. And here's also, I won't bother with the tilt at the moment here, but there's a north and south pole here. And so we can draw the equator, which we always like in there. That's, of course, at 0 degrees. And we can draw this northernmost line up here and this southernmost line up here. And they have names. This northernmost line here is called the Tropic of Cancer. And this lower line down here, called the Tropic of Capricorn. And you might guess also that these lines are definitely have a lot to do with the tilt of the earth like that, definitely linked to the tilt of the earth. And in fact, sort of the latitude of this Tropic of Cancer right here is exactly 23.5 degrees north latitude, and the latitude of the Tropic of Capricorn down here is 23.5 degrees south latitude. If you ever have trouble remembering the order of the lines here, Cancer and Capricorn, two ways you can remember it here. Just remember that the first way you can remember it is they're definitely in alphabetical order. Cancer comes before Capricorn. Also, you can remember that the shorter word comes first here. Cancer is a shorter word than Capricorn, so you can remember them that way. And looking at the Earth this way, you can just sort of summarize everything that we've been doing in the last couple of videos this way. We can say, okay, we can draw a point on the equator like that and go, okay, I know that the sun is here on about 320, March 20th. And as the year goes on, the sun gradually creeps up here to this northernmost line here and reaches this point here on June 20th, and then comes back down and hits the equator like this again on about September 20th. Let's just go with something like that, 920. And then it sort of keeps going down to its southernmost point like this on 1220. And then it sort of starts going back towards the equator right here on, makes it back there on 320 again. Then, of course, the cycle repeats itself. Maybe put a 5 here instead of the June, just keep consistent there. And so we see on March 20th on the equator, June 20th. 20th, as further north as it's going to get, comes back to the equator September 20th, down to the Tropic of Capricorn on December 20th, then back up to the equator on March 20th. So this is definitely, I think, encapsulates the entire sort of, I'll just sum this up here, this one figure here to me effects of the Earth's tilt. Sort of all encapsulated in this one figure here. You can answer all three of those questions about, is the sun always over the equator? Does it always set due west? Why do we have seasons? The whole thing is sort of all encapsulated in this one figure here. And you get to see here that the geography of the earth here is actually sort of more or less about three lines. The Tropic of Cancer, number two, the equator, and number three, the Tropic of Capricorn. So those three lines are all sort of linked to the sun, and sort of gives us some geographical reference points that are linked to the sun's motion throughout the year.